Hello, this is Dr. Grande. Welcome to my video on calculating the effect size after a Mann-Whitney U test in SPSS. As always, if you find this video useful, please like it and subscribe to my channel. I certainly appreciate it. I have here in the data editor an SPSS fictitious data I'll be using for this example. I have an independent variable named treatment and has two levels, psychodynamic therapy and treatment as usual. And then I have two dependent variables. One is named depression and the other substance use. And we can assume these scores come from a psychometric instrument designed to capture these constructs. So we want to determine if there's a difference between the psychodynamic group and the treatment as usual as measured on each of these dependent variables. And we'll assume this is going to be done with separate tests. So not a MANOVA, not including both dependent variables at the same time, but rather like a t-test for the depression dependent variable and a t-test for the substance use. However, what happens if we violate the assumptions for a t-test? In that instance, we would use a Mann-Whitney U. It's the non-parametric alternative to a t-test. So with these variables, in this example, if I go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, and Explore, and I move treatment over to the factor list, it's an independent variable, and depression and substance use over to the dependent list, under Plots, uncheck stem and leaf, check off histogram, and check off normality plots with tests. Click Continue. So what I'm testing for here is to see if the dependent variables are normally distributed for each level of the independent variable, which would be an assumption of a t-test. All right, that's an assumption for t-test. In this case, we're going to violate that assumption after interpreting the results of Shapiro-Wilk. So in the output here, moving down to the test or normality, we have the Kolmogorov-Smirnov and Shapiro-Wilk. I'm using Shapiro-Wilk here. And we can see in this table, the null hypothesis for this test, Shapiro-Wilk, is that the scores in the dependent variable were sampled from a normal distribution. So in order to assume that the data in the dependent variable are normally distributed, we would need to fail to reject the null hypothesis. And that would mean we'd have a non-statistically significant finding, as we do here for treatment as usual and depression and psychodynamic substance use. 0.110 is above 0.05 and 0.057 is above 0.05. So those are not statistically significant and we would fail to reject the null hypothesis. So we would retain the null hypothesis and say that those scores were sampled from a normal distribution. However, for psychodynamic depression and treatment as usual, substance use, we have a statistically significant finding in both these cases, 0.014 and 0.042. That is statistically significant. So in this case, we would reject the null hypothesis that the scores were sampled from the normal distribution. So in an instance like this, if we make the assumption that we have failed to meet the normality assumption for t-test, we would conduct a Mann-Whitney U. And to do that, we'll go to Analyze, Non-Parametric Tests, Legacy Dialogues, Two Independent Samples. And under this Two Independent Samples Tests dialog, notice the Mann-Whitney U test is checked off by default. And here we would have treatment as the grouping variable, the independent variable, and depression and substance use. So this is two separate tests. This is two Mann-Whitney U tests. This, as I mentioned before, this isn't combining these variables as we would in MANOVA. Now here in this dialogue, we're going to need to define the groups. So how do we know what values to use here for group 1 and group 2. So I close out of this, go back to the data editor, Up here there's A1 key on the ribbon. You can see psychodynamic is coded as 0 and treatment as usual is coded as 1. You could also go to the variable view and see it under values. 0 equals psychodynamic, 1 equals treatment as usual. So going back to the Mann-Whitney U, treatment in the grouping variable, depression substance use, in the test variable list. Now we go to define groups. We know that group 1 is 0, group 2 is 1. Click continue, and then click OK. So of interest here will be the results of Mann-Whitney U, specifically the p-value for depression and for substance use. And we can see that for depression, we fail to reject the null hypothesis. It's 0.361. So here we assume there is no difference between the groups, between psychodynamic and treatment as usual, as measured on a dependent variable depression. For substance use, however, we have a statistically significant result, 0.000011. We would reject the null hypothesis and assume there is a difference between the psychodynamic and treatment as usual levels of the independent variable treatment as measured on the substance use variable. So from this point, how do we calculate the effect size? We have the p-value, and we know we have a non-statistically significant finding for depression and a statistically significant finding for substance use, but we don't have the effect size. So moving over to Excel, I have built out this Excel worksheet so we can calculate the effect size. And the effect size I'm going to use here is R equals Z divided by the square root of N. And I'll also show you how to calculate R squared in two different ways. So first I'm going to collect the values I need for this table to the left. So for the depression variable, I move back to the output. You can see that the Z score is negative 0.914. Negative 0.914. So I'll enter that in to the z score. Z squared will be equal sign, and then the z score, shift 6 for caret, and then 2. So z squared. And we know from the example it's 50. The sample size is 25 in each group. It's 50. And the square root of n be equal sign. SQRT, and then selecting the sample size 50, it's 7.07. So moving back to the output, we can see here under ranks the total for depression 50 and the total for substance use is 50 as well. So now to calculate the effect size for the depression variable, and moving over here to cell G4, we can see we have the equation R equals Z divided by square root of N. So this will be equal sign Z divided by the square root of N here in cell D5. That effect size is negative 0.12. So what about the effect size for the substance use variable? Well, we'll just do the same thing except using the Z score from the Mann-Whitney U results table for substance use, and the sample size from substance use, which of course is the same in this example. So moving back to the output, the z-score for substance use, negative 4.394. Move up here, negative 4.394. And I don't need to make any changes to the sample size. We have an effect size of negative 0.62. So this is to calculate R. This is the value of R. What about R squared? Well, you can just square the value you have here. All right, so I do that. It's equal sign negative 0.62, shift 6 for the caret, 2, so 0.38. Or we could use the equation z squared divided by n. So it'd be equal sign z squared from over here, d3, divided by the sample size, 50. It's the same value, 38.6%. So this is R squared, it's also eta squared in this case, and it means that 38.6% of the variance in the dependent variable, in this case substance use, can be explained by the independent variable. I hope you found this video on calculating the effect size after a Mann-Whitney U test to be helpful. As always, if you have any questions or concerns, feel free to contact me. I'll be happy to assist you.